Orgasmic Enlightenment, where the sexual and spiritual come together. I'm Kim Anami, and I'm a holistic sex and relationship coach and a vaginal weightlifter. In this show, we explore all things intimate. I believe that our sexual energy is life force, creative energy, and we can use it to shape our worlds, strengthen our relationships, and self-actualize. I blend the most avant-garde information from neuroscience, ancient sexual practices like Tantra and Taoism, to renegade wellness modalities to show you how to create gourmet sex in your lives. Come one, come all. Sexual healing for men. I speak a lot about the importance of clearing sexual blockages. This is with the idea that we are all innately sexual beings, voracious, orgasmic, and libidinous, all of us. What gets in the way of us expressing our true sexual selves are our blocks, and in the case of men, the true potential of their cocks. So when I talk about blocks, I am talking about the unresolved traumas, negative experiences, and even beliefs that we have absorbed from our families and the culture at large that cut us off from the free flow of our life force sexual energy. Men and women have some of the same blocks and others that differ based on their sex. For example, sexual abuse and trauma can be experienced by both sexes, but circumcision, at least in the Western world, is a block typically experienced by men. Statistically, men are sexually abused less than women, but it still happens. And maybe in some ways, it's taken less seriously because, you know, men, they're strong and resilient. And the effects of abuse may show up differently for them. In women, the residue of sexual abuse and trauma tends to show up more as inverted sexual behavior, such as low libido, disinterest in sex, or having pain upon intercourse. And in some, it shows up as over-sexualized behavior, i.e. overt sexuality, really showing it off in kind of an aggressive way, very tits in your face, did you see my titties kind of thing. And I think it's the opposite with men. Since men culturally receive more permission to be sexual than women, I think the first place they go to is over-sexualized behavior. And then a smaller percentage of them introvert their sexuality, becoming more asexual. Either way, sexual abuse and violations, and I include routine circumcision as abuse and a violation, taint our natural sexual expression. I have an amazing podcast I put out last year called Circumvent the Circumcision, which features an interview with Brendan Marotta, the director of the incredible documentary American Circumcision. That episode is a deep dive into the reality of this choice, how there is no medical or scientific reason for it, and the ramifications it has on the male psyche and body. All of these things place a layer, a mutation over top of our innate sexuality, and if left unhealed, people can be handicapped by these things for life. In my work, this is fundamental to be addressed. It is foundational work. If this isn't healed in the nervous system and the psyche, it shows up in all sorts of untoward ways. In men, this ranges from premature ejaculation, impotency, low libido, porn addiction, emotional numbness, and an inability to identify or articulate feelings, growths or issues on the reproductive organs, such as with the prostate or testicles, a separation between the cock and the heart, which often shows up as promiscuity, and buying into the cultural narrative that it's cool to fuck a lot of chicks or dudes and not care about them. So Western medicine makes no connection between any kind of physical or emotional trauma and the resulting manifestations in one's body or their capacity for intimacy. To them, these things are just just random ailments people get and great financial opportunities for allopathic doctors to band-aid them with any number of pharmaceutical drugs or surgeries without ever finding the root cause and an actual solution. And that's where I come in. I'm all about the root causes, ha ha ha, to my Aussie friends, and a permanent transformation and resolution of symptoms. And it can be done for all of these conditions, naturally and holistically. Until we clear these blocks out of our emotional bodies and our nervous systems, it's very difficult, if not impossible, to build a vital, healthy, transformative sex life. It's like having a leak. And these things are that, energetic leakages. And no matter what you add to the vessel, however amazing the thing might be that you put into it, it's still slipping out. So the good news is that as soon as you embark on this journey and begin the process of illuminating your possible blocks and making the effort to clear them, you start healing. And you don't have to be finished to feel good or to be in a relationship. No one ever is finished. But the very act of getting in motion is huge, and it sends a signal to your entire system that you have moved out of protection and into growth. Remember what Bruce Lipton says. I have a great podcast with him, Quantum Love and Healing, that came out a few months ago. And he talks about how an organism or a cell is either in protection or growth. It cannot be in both at the same time. So when you're in protection, which is what I would call the state of having unhealed trauma, you can't grow. There's an arrest of the system. It's on pause. It's looking for ways, desperately looking for ways to release what it's holding on to. And it signals the body, right? It signals the body, the mind, with these symptoms. You know, we call them, well, things have become normalized. I talk so much about the normalization of dysfunction, especially via Western medicine, where all these symptoms and ailments are just normal, part of life. But no, these are actually messages from the higher self to let us know where to look. So as soon as you flip that switch and you commit to growth, then you are off to the races. And as Goethe says, when we commit, quote, providence moves to all sorts of things happen to help one that would never otherwise have occurred. A whole stream of events issues from the decision, raising in one's favor all manner of unforeseen incidents and meetings and material assistance, which no man could have dreamed would have come his way. Boldness has genius, power, and magic in it. Begin it now. So depending on the issues, people can need more in-depth healing and modalities. But here are five power tools I recommend for men to become self-actualized supercocks in mind and body. Oh, you ask, what is a self-actualized supercock? Well, it's a cock that's lit. It loves itself, and the man loves his cock. The cock is an extension of the man. He's truly occupying himself and it. When he truly loves himself, by extension, he loves his cock. He struts proudly with that thing. He occupies it. He inhabits it to its full power. He uses it with great care, and he realizes what a source of power his cock is, and hopefully he finds a woman who realizes that as well. In fact, this light of genitalia is what all great spiritual leaders talk about. Surely it's what Marianne Williamson was talking about in her famous quote about shining your light. Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? You are a child of God. Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you. We are all meant to shine as children do. We were born to make manifest the glory of God that is within us. It's not just in some of us, it's in everyone. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. So How is that quote not all about cock? Your playing small does not serve the world. There is nothing enlightened about shrinking. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. Truly, your cock was meant to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous. So let it rise to the occasion. Please, women everywhere, beg of you. So here's how to get there. First thing I would suggest is testicle massage. So this is the equivalent to breast massage in women. In a culture that separates sex from, well, life, it's no surprise that people dissociate from their sexual organs. So this dissociation manifests as body parts that, because they have been so disowned, end up being cut off. And sometimes literally, wombs are removed, prostates are taken out, breasts are chopped off. Ah, if only we loved our body parts more, maybe they would stick around. The worst case scenario is people being so disconnected from their sexual organs that they shrivel away. The best case scenario is that you are so in tune with your sexuality and you love and own and inhabit your genitals so much that they grow. Breasts can grow, penises can grow, and cojones, both literal and metaphorical, can grow. So testicle massage boosts testosterone production and enlivens the balls because, you know, we want men with big cojones. So you can start there, even a few minutes a day in the shower of a gentle testicle massage. You roll the balls between your thumbs and forefingers, all of your fingers, and then you stroke them in one direction with the thumbs and then go back in the other direction with your thumbs as you breathe deeply into your belly and your pelvis. A few minutes a day is all it takes. Second up, I would recommend our Resurrect Crystal Elixir, which is sold in the Anami Alchemia online shop. So this is in my Anami Crystal Elixir series, which I have personally created myself, and I have made a trilogy set for men and one for women that focus on deep healing and clearing blocks. Crystals are excellent tools, especially for working on deep-seated emotional and psychological patterns. So Resurrect is all about strengthening your erection and direction in life. In this remedy for men, it includes a set of three different crystals, rhodochrosite, chrysoprase, and rose quartz. Rhodochrosite is meant to be the crystal on the planet for dealing with any kind of sexual abuse and trauma, including circumcision. It's also a prime crystal of self-love and confidence, feeling at ease in your own skin, and truly loving who you are, and of taking responsibility for your own stuff. So rather than getting stuck in a blame game and projecting onto other people, you draw that focus onto you and what you can do to move forward. And then we have rose quartz, which helps to unite the heart and the cock. The great chasm in our modern sexually fucked up world is the mammoth gap between heart and genitals, and perhaps much more so apparent with men. So the self-actualized cock may respond to all sorts of superficial stimulation, but at its core, it's most aroused and made erect by the steamy combination of gourmet sex, which has emotional openness and physical abandon combined. A deep, soul-stirring pull that marshals all of its erectile and divine healing power into action and fucks the world and his woman into smithereens. And that, my loves, is the true purpose of cock, to be relentless and penetrating. It opens, it probes, it finds truth, and it smashes it into aliveness and illuminates some vaginas along the way. Rose quartz is also a fertility stone, and it helps to resolve deep-seated father issues. Chrysoprase is next in the trinity. It's known for its get up and go. It's all about being decisive, taking action, and it's an antidote to analysis paralysis. So it gets you out of the head and into your body and into action. It also helps to remove the sense of acting out of duty or obligation in your life, which is a common trap for men. And it helps to bring you into alignment with what really fulfills you and is a true expression of your gifts in the world. My third recommendation as a healing practice would be lingam massage. And I am separating out lingam and testicle massage. So testicle massage is a daily practice that only takes a few minutes. Lingam massage would be a longer, drawn out, very deliberately focused, and even lavish experience. You can massage yourself or have a partner massage you. The purpose of conscious lingam massage rather than just, say, a hand job is that, like any therapeutic massage, we're looking at releasing tension and, in this case, even stored trauma to help reconnect to the cock. It's a great tool to bring awareness and aliveness back into the cock and to bridge any kind of dissociation. In these massages, we want to open, release, heal, and activate the true power and potential of your wand of light, which is the Sanskrit definition of the word lingam, cock. Remember the lit cock. So the cock is full of all kinds of reflexology points. In fact, the entire reflexology map of all of your internal organs is laid out on the surface area of your cock. Every time you stimulate it, ideally in its entirety, from balls to shaft to tip, through self-pleasure, intercourse, or conscious massage, you are giving yourself a euphoric acupressure treatment. And you can do this on your own, and it's also amazing to receive lingam massage from your partner. The intent is less to bring you to orgasm, though if that happens, that's fine, but you want to dwell more in the space of releasing, activating, soothing, and healing. That is really your intention with this. So I have a great video on my YouTube channel on lingam massage to inspire you. My next suggestion would be a pelvic weightlifting practice. Yes, cocks can and ought to lift weights too. Penile weightlifting is the male equivalent to the female yoni egg practice. Cocks need exercise too. So having a strong PC muscle gives you power and confidence, stamina control, stronger erections, and orgasm. So what's not to love? You can develop agility and more conscious movement and occupation of your cock as it becomes more sentient. So I've been with people who had a very committed weightlifting strengthening practice, and wow, there's a huge difference between a cock that's alive and is really able to move itself around your vagina rather than just all that movement coming from the hips. It's actually coming from the cock as this much more alive, as I said, sentient being. It's a big difference. And so for the man, this really restores a lot, again, of this connection and power and confidence, the resurrection, right? So I have a full weightlifting routine in my Sexual Mastery for Men Salon for penile weightlifting. Speaking of which, my next suggestion would be my Sexual Mastery for Men Salon. So this is my signature 8-week online program for men to become sexual masters of themselves and their woman. We dive deep into your body and hers. So in the salon, we cover everything from deeper healing modalities to release trauma, detoxing from porn, how to build sting-like stamina and separate orgasm from ejaculation, cock exercises to lengthen, strengthen, and grow cock organically, how to channel your sexual energy as a creative power, increasing your vitality, confidence, and cash flow. As I said, a pelvic weightlifting routine, Orgasmopedia, the guide to female orgasms, especially the deeper vaginal life-changing orgasms like G-spot and cervical, how to find your masculine expression in the world, and how to man up in today's hostile to masculine energy type climate. We need good, solid men in these times now more than ever. The Sexual Mastery for Men Salon opens for registration soon. For the free preview video series, you can watch with exercises you can practice tonight to build stamina. Come to my site at kimanami.com, look for Sexual Savant Salons, and then click on Sexual Mastery for Men. Thank you so much for listening. If you haven't already, subscribe and also leave a review and send someone else the gift of a healthy libido and an off-the-charts love life by sharing this episode with them. We'll be back next week, and in the meantime, many happy orgasms. Mm-hmm.